we would talk more about Viceregal Lodge and history associated with it. But before that, we would go to another residence of Viceroy of India. It was called Retreat and it was located at Mashobra, 6 miles east from Shimla. What Shimla was to Calcutta, thick wooded Mashobra was to Shimla. It was a place of relief for the Viceroy from the official work, dinners and ball dances, functions and garden parties. The man behind acquisition and building of the retreat was Lord Elgin, Viceroy of India from 1894 to 1899. He acquired it, a small wooden house, in 1896. From one Englishman, it was to be a suburban residence for the Viceroys of India. Mashobra was an ideal weekend destination. It lay on the ridge stretching away to Mahasu Hill Peak. Today, it is an upscale, densely forested, less crowded stretch with houses of super rich and famous. Elgin's father, James Bruce, was also a Viceroy of India during 1862 to 1863, just for 1 year, when he died at district Lahaul Spiti because of heart attack. And he was the first occupant of Peterhouse residence. One interesting statement attributed to Elgin was that he said, "India is the pivot, a jewel for their empire, British Empire. If the empire lost a part, the British could survive. But if they lost India, they would be doomed." During Elgin's tenure, the infamous 1896 famine broke out and millions of Indians died. Historians do not rate Elgin as a good viceroy, as a great administrator. Thus, 1896 onward, the Viceroy of India had two residences at Shimla, one at Viceroy Lodge at Observatory Hill and the other, the Retreat at Mashobra. Elgin spent time at Retreat on the weekend days with his family members. He preferred walking. He did not ride a horse. He loved spending time in the woods of Mashobra. The retreat was like a simple English cottage. It was built in the design consisting of local features of Himalayas and Himachal Pradesh called Dhaji and European elements. The walls were made of wooden frames packed with a stone, mortar of clay or baked limes. The sloping roof was made of blue grit slate. The floor and ceiling were wooden. It had an attic, large bedrooms, a veranda. The complex had several structures and huts for accommodating men on bandobast and security duty of the Viceroy. Currently, Retreat is painted chocolate brown. It has spread big, beautiful lawns. One has a wider view of mountain ranges, always covered with snow, endless apple orchards and dense deodar forest. The temperature here is a bit lower than Shimla, but the retreat was not made to withstand winter cold, as His Excellency the Viceroy was supposed to live here during the summer days. A mile-long road with tall and thick deodar trees standing both sides of the road connect the famous Hindustan-Tibet road to the retreat. The retreat was surrounded by big ferns, wildflowers, lilies and baby orchids. The Viceroy returned to Shimla on Monday morning on a rickshaw. The return journey was downhill, wonderful view of the hills and the mountains around. During the Shimla Agreement in 1972, the then Prime Minister of India, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, stayed here. Now the retreat is a property of the central government. It is Rashtrapati Nivas and His Excellency, President of India, visits the place during summer. Lot many interesting historical incidents, men and women are associated with retreat. We would discuss about them. Thank you for watching.